Hi everyone. So in this video we are going to see how to construct a triangle when two sides and angle between them is given. So we have taken an isosceles triangle ABC. In that the angle between them and the two sides they have given. First of all we will construct the rough diagram. So they have given that the side AB is 6.5 cm. And BC is 6.5 cm and angle between them is 110 degree. So BC is 6.5 cm. So ABC is the required triangle. So with the help of compass and protractor, we are going to construct this triangle. So first we have to draw the baseline for 6.5 cm. So the base is 6.5. So A, B, 6.5 cm. So after that we have to make an angle 110 degree. So with the vertex B we are going to make that angle. See, we have kept the protractor in vertex B, right? So we are having that arm AB here, right? One leg is here, then we have to find the moving leg. So that will go along the outer angle. So 0, 10, 20, 30 up to 110. So 100, 110 here I am getting. So here we have to keep a point. See children, this is not the point C. This is not vertex, okay? So we have to join and make an angle 110 degree. Then with the help of compass, we have to draw an arc for 6.5 cm, right? BC is 6.5, right? So you just measure 6.5 cm. So here AB is 6.5. So I am taking the same measurement. So with B as center, we have to draw one. So the dark and the arc and the straight line. See, the arc and the straight line is meeting at a point, right? That is our vertex C. So this is 6.5 cm. Now join A and C, we will get the required triangle. So ABC is our required triangle, children. So this is how we have to construct a triangle when two sides and the angle between them has been given. See, since it is an isosceles triangle, we are getting two equal sides. We can get in scale and triangle also. Okay, there they will be provided the two different sides. See, now we are going to construct a triangle when two angles and one side has been given. See, they have given the triangle base as EF 5 cm and angle E 50 degree and angle C 60 degree. So EFG is the triangle. So first we have to draw the base, right? So EF is 5 cm. So we can draw the base EF 5 cm. So EF 5 cm. So after that we have to make an angle with the help of protractor. So first we have to keep the protractor on the point vertex E. See, the 0 is coinciding with inner 0, we are getting, right? The line EF is coinciding with inner 0, so we have to see the inner angle 50 degree. So here we are getting 50 degree, so we can draw a line. One more time, let me repeat, children, this is not our vertex G, right? Okay, so again we have to keep the protractor in vertex F. So that we have to construct angle 60 degree. Now the arm is coinciding with the 0 outer, right? Outer 0 it is coinciding. So outer angle we have to check 60 degree. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Right. Now we have to join these two points. This is 60 degree and this is 50 degree, right? See children, the two angles are intersecting at one point, right? That is our vertex G. Is it clear, children? See, for some angles, if it is not intersecting, we can extend that line up to. Okay, however we need, we can extend that lines. Okay. So this is how we have to construct a triangle when two angles and the included side has been given. So now we are going to construct a right angled triangle. It is an right angled isosceles triangle. So they have given that the angle ACB is 90 degree. So we can have angle ACB 90 degree they have given. So the isosceles sides they have given is AC 6 cm and B BC 6 cm. So now we are going to construct a right angled triangle. Right. So first we can construct the base. See, here I have taken BC as the base. If you are willing to take AC as the base also, you can take. So I have taken BC as the base. So BC 6 cm. Now we have to make an angle 90 degree, right? So without using the protractor, now we are going to check how to construct 90 degree, right? So for that, what we have to do, we can take any radius in the compass. So we can take 1 or 2 cm. So if you are taking 2 cm, it will be little bit comfortable for you children. So you can take 2 cm. So now I am also taking 2 cm. So from vertex C, angle 90 degrees in vertex C, right? So from vertex C, we have to draw one semicircle, right? See, if it is needed, we can extend this point BC. So from vertex C, again I am extending this line BC, so that you can extend it using dotted line, then it will be easier for us, right? Okay, so either we can draw a semicircle or you can draw two arcs on the line BC like this. The two arcs alone we can draw. Okay, after that you can take this two point as C1 and C2. See, here we are getting a vertex C, right? So I have taken C1 and C2. If it is E1, E2, we can take. If it is H1, H2, we can take, right? For our convenient, we are taking. Now we have to measure C1 and C2 using compass. So at one point we have to keep the protractor compass point, and another one we have to keep the pencil, right? So now we have to measure C1 and C2 with the help of compass. Compass pointer on one point and the pencil on the another. See, now I have measured C1 and C2. See, I have measured exactly, right? Now with this one, we have to draw an arc above the point C from C1 and C2 with the same measurement. C2 and C1, we have to draw two arcs above the point C. After that, we can take this as C2. For C3, for our reference, we are taking this point as C3. Now join C and C3, we will get 90 degree. See, I got 90 degree. You can check with the help of protractor. So now we are getting exact 90 degree. Right, after that we have to construct the AC 6 cm. So with the help of compass, we are going to construct AC 6 cm. So measure AC 6 cm in scale, and with C as center, draw one arc. So the line, 90 degree line, and the arc is meeting, right? That is our point A, right? So join A and B, we will get the required right angle triangle. So this is how we have to construct 90 degree, children. If they are asking you to construct 90 degree without protractor, we can construct it easily with the help of compass, right? So first we have to draw two arcs from the point where we are getting 90 degree, right? From that vertex we have to draw two arcs on either side. After that we have to measure the two sides with the help of compass. Then with that measurement we have to draw two arcs above that line. See, we have to measure C1 and C2 with the help of compass like this. After that, with C1 as center and C2 as center, we have to draw two arcs above the point C. Then we have to join, we will get 90 degree. So that's all, children. Thank you.